Attic. I am your host, the Film Doctor. And here, why? Okay, first of all, no one even backhand bounces anymore. What are you doing?
Oh.
I'm hateful that you're here. I'm hateful you have a pissed shirt on.
I'm just celebrating the fact that, you know, the fans are saying that I'm surpassing you. I am becoming the Film Doctor. You know, I just want to give a shout out to all of my fans.
What do you mean the fans are surpassing? Do you think this is the 2020 election? No. Let me tell you something. You're not surpassing me in anything. You're not the Film Doctor. You don't even look like a Film Doctor. Look, this is what a Film Doctor looks like. You don't look like one. So I am the Film Doctor. You, who knows what you are?
It's interesting that you would say that.
Say what? What are you doing?
La, 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 la. La, 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 la.
What the hell is
that? Gotta get the coat on, right? Don't want to mess up the look. La, 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 la,
are you stealing clothes from my wardrobe?
Hey, don't worry about where I got this from.
Look, I'm gonna tell you something. You can put on 100 white coats. You still are not the Film anything, okay? Assistant, until further notice till I fire you. Okay, worry about it. Let's jump into movies that are coming soon.
Movies that are coming soon. Coming soon. Hey guys, this trailer that we're looking at is called Vanguard.
Hold on a second. Okay. Rewind. That's my part. I'll do that. Okay.
No, it's not.
I'll do that.
Okay. Whatever. Whatever.
You stop. Stand there. Do what you do, which no one knows. I'll do it. The movie that we're looking at today is called Vanguard. It's with Jackie Chan, who I am a huge fan of. I didn't know he was still doing movies or if he's capable of doing movies, but let's go ahead and check it out.
We are entering dangerous territory. The enemy has more men.
Lamborghini.
Okay. We're taking innocent lives.
This is our waterfalls. Oh, I love me some good action.
Bro.
Okay.
Take my money. I need not see anymore. Take my money.
Okay. Let me
just say a couple things.
Okay, Jackie Chan.
Okay, I see him. Let's just say, number one, is that why are we both grinning like 12-year-old schoolgirls? We both grinning. First of all, it's like Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, fuck Fast and Furious. Like, and both of them were on cocaine. Like, that's how sweet that was. Like, I see him. I see what he's doing.
It still had those, like, funny Jackie Chan action moments, but there looked like some good action sequences in that movie. I'd be interested to see it for sure. Full price for it, I don't know, but I'd be interested.
Bro, I wouldn't spend $30 for Mulan, but I'll spend $40 to see that.
I'm not paying $40 for that.
I'll pay $40.
Well, you'll pay $40 for the both of us. How about that?
Well, give me what you would contribute, and I'll put it towards the $40. First of all, we still grinning. Like, the movie looks so...
The trailer was good, though. The movie does look good.
It does. Do you even know what it's about from watching the trailer? I don't have a clue.
All I saw was a bunch of action scenes. Just cars going boom, doing driving.
Oh. Yeah,
I felt like Mission Impossible, Fast and Furious just... Come on,
they're coming out with a new Mission Impossible and Fast and Furious, but they better step up their damn game to catch up with Vanguard. I don't even know Vanguard number two because that one was too sweet.
Yeah.
Too sweet. I don't have any more to say. Like,
no.
Well, that's all I got to say about that. That looks really good. So that's all we have for movies that are coming soon. Let's take a look.
Guys, let's go ahead and move into new releases.
Okay, stop doing what I'm doing. You even did a finger thing. Don't do the finger thing. All right, that's me, my finger, your finger stays down there. And that's all we have for movies that are coming soon. Let's talk about new releases.
New releases. New releases. New releases.
The movie that we're reviewing for new releases is a movie called Antebellum. And it's not really a Jordan Peele movie. It actually says from the people that produced Get Out. Mm-hmm. And so therefore, I know that you already have some skewed thoughts on how this movie was. So let's not even judge it to be Jordan Peele.
I enjoy Get Out. I enjoy all Jordan Peele movies. That has nothing to do with my opinion on it, but continue.
No, I let's hear what you have to say about it, because obviously, if we can, we'll just edit your part out and we'll keep the more important part from a film perspective. But go ahead.
Okay, so my review of this movie is going to be very balanced. I think from an art and a cinematography perspective, there were a lot of good things done here. There were a lot of good camera angles, a lot of good shots. Great use of slow-mo at the end for when something happens. I'm not going to say what, but it's a great use of slow-mo at the end of the movie. I think the art concept is great. Now, and the cinematography is more than good. I have two big issues. The first big issue is I am tired of slave movies. I exhausted by them. Black people did more than just be slaves. Number one. Number two. Okay.
I'm listening.
It uses the same slave tropes that every single slave movie has. I am so sick of slave movies. Hollywood, if you are hearing me, which you will be watching this show one day, because we are going to be the premiere review show. I guarantee it. Stop making slave movies. Thank you.
Okay.
My second issue is that this movie was supposed to be about how America couldn't get past its demons of the past. But the movie skews its own concept at the end. And I'm not going to give away the end of the movie, but it skews its own concept at the end of the movie. It completely skews its own concept. It's hard. Like, I wish, can we do a spoiler section for this? So I don't look like silly and I can explain exactly why I'm saying what I'm saying.
First of all, you look silly regardless. That's my two biggest issues with this film.
The cinematography was great. I don't have issues with the acting.
All right, so we're going to ignore me. Okay.
Yeah, because I'm reviewing. You're going to sit there and be quiet while I'm reviewing. The cinematography is great.
I can't wait to fire your ass.
I didn't have any issues with the acting. I didn't think the acting was bad or anything like that. It's just like a concept thing and the movie genre type of thing that really bothers me, and I'm tired of it. So, with that being said, my grade for this movie is going to be a C+.
This is exactly why.
Now you may give.
No, I'm sorry. Your time is up. I'm going to say that that's exactly why you're the film nurse or the film assistant or the soon to be film unemployed employee. The fact of the matter is that that is too low of a rating. I don't care what you say. Don't look like you're about to talk. Shut the hell up. That's what you would do right now. I will say this. Number one is that to say you're tired of slave movies, stop making slave movies, blah, blah, blah. They're trying to make every slave movie look like, that's like watching a horror movie with a killer. Like, oh my God, why does he always have to kill people? Oh my God, I'm so tired of him killing people. Oh my God. And then there's Halloween 8 or 9. Oh my God, I'm so tired of Halloween movies. I'm tired of scary movies. They keep coming out with a scary movie every October.
This coming from the guy that complains about Hollywood not having new ideas.
Wait.
How can I do it so pointed?
Mr. Film Assistant, I'm speaking.
This guy right here complains about Hollywood not having new ideas.
So like I said, because obviously you don't realize when it's my turn.
I'm saying, people.
So from my perspective, from a film professional perspective, I will say that the movie, it didn't have amazing cinematography throughout. There was a couple of scenes that were really good. It did not have amazing acting. Janelle Monáe or whatever her name is. Isn't that a singer, I believe?
Yeah, she's also an artist.
They, They should have found an actual actress. It's not to say that she did a bad job, but I feel like if they would have taken somebody else that was an actress that could have brought something to that role, that would have been even more impactful with the acting. So I can't say that the acting was phenomenal. It wasn't bad. There's nothing that I can say that's bad about, certain things about the movie, but I will say that the storyline is different. It was that kind of Jordan Peele surprise ending to me. I didn't know anything about it going into it. And I will say, looking at it, I'm like, oh my God, another slave movie. What direction are they going? How is this supposed to be good? And then certain things happen. There are certain calls that were made in this film, if you know what I mean, no spoiler, that really was like, how is that possible? What's going on? And then I'm like, it really was making sense. It really was something like an M. Night Shyamalan and Jordan Peele kind of meshed movie within that consensus. And so therefore it was appreciated for the story. So because some of the other things were not phenomenal in my eyes from a film perspective, I still think as a story, it was enjoyable. It was slow and kind of trying to understand what direction they were going to. First of all, your face, I don't even want to see it far away, let alone up close.
What was that word you just said?
Anyway, if I had to give it a rating, I'm going to give it a B or a B plus. I can't really give it an exact one on that because I feel like for anybody that sees it, it's worth seeing. It's not an A plus, A minus kind of range. It's not that great of a movie because of, how long it took you to get into it. And like I said, that's not important when it takes a long time to get into it. If the ending makes sense and the ending is good, it can sell for the whole movie. But I know if I'm giving that review to other people that are viewing it, other people that view movies, especially in this day and age, can't handle sitting down there for 30 minutes and they haven't seen an explosion like in Vanguard, where we're just getting explosion after explosion. I mean, that was phenomenal. I'll do one with you. it was that good. So I'm going to give it a B+. I think that it was definitely well worth seeing. And you could watch with somebody and be able to enjoy it. So that's my review.
I would not tell people to buy this film. Brief spoilers, people. Brief spoilers. So that was the end of our kind of review thing. And I'm going to make my review make a little bit more sense. So brief spoilers. At the end of the movie, right, we learn that...
Are you about to spoil this? Why? Why are you about to spoil this?
Hey, listen, we're going to have another episode full of spoilers.
Well, we don't have to because we ain't spoiling here today. That's all we got today for Filmatic. If you haven't seen this, called Antebellum, go ahead and check it out. Like we said last episode, this is episode 41. We are going to keep doing every episode an announcement about our giveaway. All you have to do is like, comment, and subscribe. That's all. That's all you have to do in order to enter the competition, enter the giveaway, and you will be entered for an opportunity to win a $25 gift card to Best Buy. So that's all. I want to thank everybody for tuning in. I want to thank the former film nurse / unemployed employee.
You know what? I'm going to evolve. I think it's time for me to evolve. You can be the film doctor. It's time for me to go to a higher level.
I'm going to need you to get rid of that jacket and stop copying me and doing everything.
It's time for me to go to a higher level.
You're not doing any higher level, all right? We're not going to keep going through this. So anyway, thank you everybody for joining. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe in order to enter the giveaway. And as always, this has been another exciting episode of Filmatic. Still slow.